Each year, we hear about another hurricane, cyclone, or typhoon bearing down on a coastal city and battering it with stormy weather strong enough to cause all kinds of damage. But what actually is a hurricane and what causes them? Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
Each year, around 150 hurricanes form all across the globe in the warm ocean waters near the equator. These massive storms are called hurricanes in the Atlantic Ocean, Caribbean Sea, Gulf of Mexico, and Eastern Pacific Ocean. But in the Western Pacific, they're known as typhoons. In the Southern Pacific and Indian Oceans, they're called cyclones, and scientists call them all tropical cyclones, no matter where they happen. But no matter what you call them, you'll best recognize one by its colossal size, distinctive swirly shape, and big blank spot in the middle, known as the eye of the storm. They form over warm tropical ocean water, as the warm air floating just above the water rises and is replaced by cooler air higher in the sky. Now that it's closer to the warm ocean, the cool air will start to warm up and rise, making a cycle. If this cycle starts to happen fast enough, it can cause huge storm clouds to form. Those massive clouds begin to spin. As the spinning cycle continues to suck up hot air, the spiral gets stronger and the winds get faster. When winds get to 39 miles an hour, the weather system officially becomes known as a tropical storm. These are plenty strong enough to cause damage and flooding. Once the wind speed reaches 75 miles per hour, well, that's when the storm is officially considered a hurricane. Some super strong hurricanes have been known to have winds stronger than 200 miles per hour. And if strong winds weren't dangerous enough, hurricanes also tend to be pretty large, typically around 300 miles across, sometimes up to 600 miles. Not only that, but these storms also move slowly, usually just 10 to 20 miles per hour. That means there's plenty of time for a hurricane to pass overhead, wreaking havoc for upwards of a week at a time. Strong winds and driving rain for miles and miles, all creeping along at a snail's pace. Well, no wonder hurricanes are known for causing so much damage. Most hurricanes build momentum out in the water, but once they hit land, they slowly start to lose strength. Why? Well, without the warm water below to heat up the air, the cycle short circuits and the storm starts to shrink and slow down. Hurricanes might start to die out over land, but it's also when they do the most damage. Storm surges, flooding, downed trees, and flying debris from high-speed winds all make the coast extra dangerous when a hurricane's overhead. So, if you live near a coast that gets hit by hurricanes, cyclones, or typhoons, don't panic. Just make sure to stay prepared, stay safe, and stay alert. Oh, and expect a few things to get wet.